Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Gems of Knowledge. So I am here with another video on the chapter Matter in Our Surrounding. Okay, so previously we have studied about the solid state, liquid state as well as the gaseous state. So today we are here to study, can matter change its states? Okay, so before starting my video, make sure to subscribe to my channel and also click on the bell button to get the notification to the earliest. Okay, so we all know that matter is existing in only three states, that is solid, liquid and gas. So far we have studied about the three states of matter, that is solid, liquid and gas. Okay, so here what happens inside the matter? Okay, so here we are going to study what happens inside the matter when the during the change of the state. Okay, what happens to the particles during the change of states? Okay, so to all these questions here we need to study, can matter change its state? Okay, so you all can see here it is possible in the below two conditions. Okay, so this is possible in below two conditions, that is due to change in temperature and due to change in pressure. Okay, so these are the two conditions where we can say the matter can change its state. Either it is from solid to liquid or liquid to gas or gaseous to any other state or whatever it is, but the matter can change its states only in the two possible conditions, that is change in temperature and change in pressure. Okay, so let us study one by one what is this change in temperature and change in pressure. So first one, you can see here effect of change of temperature is been given. So we are going to study about this first, that is how the temperature can affect the changes in the state of the matter. Okay, so you can see the first point here. On increasing the temperature of solid, the kinetic energy increases. Obviously, we know that when we increases the temperature in case of solid, what happens there is kinetic energy will be increasing just because the particles will start moving. Okay, so you can see due to the increase of the kinetic energy, as the kinetic energy is increasing there, what happens there is the particles start vibration with a great speed. Okay, so you all know here in the solid state all the particles are tightly packed. Okay, so when you try to increase the temperature over here, what happens is these molecules will try to shake themselves. Okay, this molecules will try to shake themselves. Okay, as a result what happens there is the force of attraction between this molecules will be slowly it has been releasing, the force will be overcoming due to the presence of this heat. Okay, or the due to this temperature. Okay, so what happens as the kinetic energy of the particles will increase here, the particles will start vibrating with a great speed. Okay, the energy supplied by heat overcomes the force of attraction between the particles. So what happens as we provide heat here, the force of attraction between these particles will be loosen up. Okay, and as a result what happens, these particles will try to move to a distinct places. Okay, after giving heat to these molecules it will be like this. Okay, it means there will be some force, the force of attraction will be loosened up and there will be some gaps formed. It means now your solid is converted into liquid. Okay, so you can see here the particles leave their fixed positions and start moving more freely. Okay, so now this was the fixed position in case of solid. Okay, now as the force of attraction is overcome here and the increased in kinetic energy, what happens is these particles will little bit try to move freely, means this solid is converted into the liquid state. Okay, means you can see here a stage is reached when the solid melts and it is converted into a liquid. Okay, so this is the reason how the temperature will effect of temperature can change the state from solid position to liquid position. Okay, so you can see here the temperature at which a solid melts to become a liquid at atmospheric pressure is called as its melting point. Okay, so the temperature at which the solid melt, okay, to become the liquid, that particular temperature is called as melting point. Okay, so you can see here the melting point of ice is 273.16 Kelvin. Okay, so this is the melting point of the ice. Okay, so next you can see, next you have to study few more things here about fusion and about the latent heat of fusion, latent heat of vaporization you need to study. So let us first see what is fusion. Okay, the process of melting, the process of melting, or we can say the change of solid state into liquid state is known as fusion. Okay, only the change of state from solid to liquid is known as fusion. Okay. I hope you remembered I asked you a question in my previous video that when a solid melts, its temperature remains the same. So where does the heat energy go? So here is the answer to that question. You can see a instrumental setup present on your screen, okay, in which a beaker is containing the ice and a thermometer is placed into that beaker, you can see, okay, and a flame is given from below, okay, using the burner, and the process is here, the process of melting of ice is going on, okay. Until the ice is completely melt into liquid, you can see the thermometer readings will not be shown. It will be similar to as it is. So why is this? Because you can see ice is a solid form, okay? The solid form will be converted into liquid here. So whatever the heat we are providing, whatever the temperature we are giving from the below burner, it is utilized in breaking the bonds of solid and converting it to the liquid. Okay. So this is the main reason why the temperature will remain same and the heat energy here, whatever the heat energy is utilized, it is just utilized in breaking the bonds between the solid and it is formed into a liquid. So here whatever the heat energy you are providing is in the form of hidden. So according to this hidden concept of heat, you have arisen with the latent heat of fusion. Similarly, latent heat of fusion is given. So we need to know what is this latent heat of fusion. Okay. So the particular amount of heat energy, okay, the amount of heat energy that is required to change, okay, 1 kg of solid into liquid at atmospheric pressure at its melting point. Okay, two important things here, at atmospheric pressure as well as at its melting point. Okay, this is known as latent heat of fusion. So fusion, we know what is fusion. Fusion is actually the change of state from solid to liquid. Okay, melting process is only called as fusion. So latent heat of fusion means we need to convert it from solid to liquid itself. Okay, we cannot convert from liquid to any other state or from solid to any other state, because fusion is the thing which is the process of melting, because fusion is only the thing called as melting process. Okay, that melting process is only called as fusion. So it need to be converted from solid to liquid only. It cannot be converted from solid to any other state or from liquid to any other state. We need to convert solid into liquid at the atmospheric pressure as well as at its melting point. Okay, see, these two are the conditions for this latent heat of fusion. Okay, so the particles in water at 0 degrees Celsius have more energy as compared to the particles in ice at same temperature. Okay. So water particles at 0 degree Celsius have more energy compared to the ice particles, because this ice particles will be solid, means they will be in the clustered form, whereas in the liquid what happens, they will be in this form. So they are free to move here. So they will be having more kinetic energy compared to the solid particles. Okay, so I hope this latent heat of fusion is cleared. So let us move on to latent heat of vaporization now. Okay, so here you can see latent heat of vaporization is been given. So before knowing what is latent heat of vaporization, you can see a question is popping onto your screen. So the question is, why do we see water droplets on the outer surface of the glass containing ice cold water? I hope you all have observed that when we are holding a ice cold water in a glass, you can see outer surface of the glass will be covered with the water droplets. Why is it? If you know the answer to this question, scroll down into the comment section and type your answer. If you are unaware of the answer, wait for my next video so that you get the answer to this question as well. Okay, so let us continue with our experiment. So here in the previous case, we have seen the ice were present and now the ice is converted into the liquid water. Okay, now when we supply heat energy to this water, here the particles start moving faster. Okay, and at certain temperature, a point is reached where the particles will have enough energy to break the force of attraction of each other, and the liquid is again converted into gaseous state. So this process is nothing but known as latent heat of vaporization. So here now onwards, you can see the rise of temperature in the thermometer scale, and also the water will boil and it will be converted into gaseous form. That is, formation of liquid to vapor state will start from this point. So the same case is repeated as latent heat of fusion, but there it was fusion, but here it is vaporization. Okay, so the amount of heat energy that is required to change 1 kg of liquid into vapor. So you can see vaporization means liquid will be converted into vapors at atmospheric pressure at its melting point is known as latent heat of vaporization. Okay, so the similar case. Okay, so you can see similar two conditions have been given here, that its atmospheric pressure and here melting point is given. It must be actually boiling point because your vaporization is taking place, means liquid is vaporizing to vapor. Okay, liquid is changing its state from liquid to gas. It means it should be at its boiling point. Okay, when we boil liquid, then only we will get the vapors. We cannot melt liquid again, as it is not solid. It is liquid. It will be already melted condition. Okay, so please note down this. Here it was a mistake. It is not melting point. It is actually the boiling point. Okay, then you can see here, when we supply heat energy to water, particles start moving even faster. Similar conditions there also and here also. When you supply heat energy, okay, when you supply heat to the water, what happens to the particles of water? It will be start moving even faster. Okay, so at certain temperature, what happens after few time, what happens is a point will be reached when the particles will have enough energy to break free from the forces of attraction of each other. Okay, now you know that particles of liquid will be at this distances. Okay, so when you go on applying the temperature, so at certain temperature, what happens, this molecules or this atom of particles, what happens, they will separate this bond and they will start moving randomly like this. Okay, so it means the state of liquid is being achieved to state of gas. Okay, so you can see here at this temperature, the liquid start changing into gas. Okay, the temperature at which the liquid start boiling at the atmospheric pressure is known as boiling point. Okay, so the temperature at which the liquid will start boiling, so that temperature, okay, is nothing but known as boiling point. Okay, so boiling is a bulk phenomenon. Obviously, it is a vast phenomenon. It is very big. Okay, it is a bulk phenomenon. Particles from the bulk of the liquid gain enough energy to change into vapor state. Exactly. So the what happens there is the particles will be very bulk. Okay. So when you boil one glass of liquid also, one glass of water, there will be lots of millions of particles. Okay. So that particles, okay, inside that bulk of particles, they will gain the energy. Inside that many number of particles, all the particles will gain energy, okay, and it will change into vapor state. Okay, for water, this temperature is 373 Kelvin. If you change 100 degrees Celsius, means it will be like 273 plus 100, it will comes to 373 Kelvin. Okay, so 373 Kelvin is nothing but it is 100 degree Celsius itself. Next, particles in steam. Okay, now the condition comes, what about the steam? So what happens in the steam? Particles in steam, that is water vapor at 373 Kelvin, have more energy than water at the same temperature. Okay, steam particles will have more energy than the water at the same temperature, because particle in steam have absorbed extra energy in the form of latent heat of vaporization. Okay, so steam particles will have more energy rather than the liquid water vapors, because here the latent heat of vaporization works for the particles in case of steam. Okay, now here the directly one thing is been given, solid state is changed into liquid state when heat is provided. Okay, similarly liquid state is converted into gaseous state when heat is provided, and the reverse is also possible. Gaseous state, when you cool it, okay, when you try to cool this gaseous state, it can be converted to liquid state. And the liquid state, again when you cool it, defreeze it, it can be converted into solid state. Okay, next, the last thing which you need to study in the effect of change of temperature is about the sublimation. So what is sublimation? Sublimation is nothing but a change of state directly from solid to gas without changing into liquid state. Okay, either if you change directly solid to gas, or gas to solid without coming into the liquid state, that particular state is nothing but called as sublimation. Okay, so I can give you the example of the naphthalene balls, okay, which you keep into your clothes for good smelling, the white color balls. Okay, a picture may be popping up onto the screen, you can identify it. Okay, so that is just an example for sublimation. You can see the whole ball will be present, but after few days you can see the naphthalene ball will just disappear from there. It will not come to the liquid state, it will just vaporize it. If you keep it open, it will be vaporized. After some days it will be totally disappeared from the particular example is nothing but for the sublimation. Okay, so this was about the change of temperature, effect of change of temperature. Now let us see what is the effect of change of pressure. Okay, so on applying pressure, if you apply more pressure and reduce the temperature, what you can do is you can liquefy your gases. Okay, so you can liquefy your gases. Okay, how it is possible, let us see. So here you can see a picture popping up onto the screen which shows by applying pressure how the particle of matter can be brought closer to each other. Okay, so the first case which you have seen here is nothing but the gaseous state. When the piston is applied, when the applying pressure, what happens there is the particles will be brought again closer in the second case. As you can observe, this is nothing but the liquid state, and when again the piston is applied, again the pressure is applied onto the same particles, it is formed into the solid state. You can see there is no gap between the particles of matter, which shows that the gaseous particle was first converted into liquid state and then it is again converted into the solid state. So one example is given here. You can see solid carbon dioxide. Okay, solid carbon dioxide is stored under high pressure. You know that solid carbon dioxide is always stored under the high pressure. Gaseous state on decreasing of pressure. Okay, when you decrease the pressure, it can directly change into the gaseous state. Okay, so to one atmosphere without coming to liquid state. So when you decrease the pressure to one atmosphere, so solid carbon dioxide, it can directly change into gaseous state without coming to the liquid state. Okay, so this is the reason that solid carbon dioxide is also known as dry ice. Okay, so this is just your general knowledge that this solid carbon dioxide is just known as the dry ice. Okay, so here you can see one structure has been given. So solid, when it is converted to liquid, it is called as fusion, and liquid when it is converted to gas, it is called as vaporization. You can see here, okay, direction. So gas when it is converted to solid, it is called as, you can see here down, sublimation. Okay, similarly when liquid is converted into solid, it is called as solidification. And solid when it is converted to gas, it is called as again sublimation. Liquid, it is called as condensation. Okay, so do you know this? The SI unit of temperature is Kelvin. Similarly, we can say the SI unit of pressure is Pascal. Okay, and the Kelvin is denoted by the letter K, whereas Pascal is denoted by Pa. Okay, and 1 atmosphere is equals to 1.01 into 10 to the power of 5 Pascals. Okay, so it is, the pressure can also be denoted in the form of atmosphere. So what is this atmosphere? Atmosphere is a unit of measuring pressure exerted by a gas. Okay, I hope the concept is cleared here. So depending on this concept, let's quickly move on to the question answer section of this part. Okay, so here are few questions which are related to the change of matter in its states. Okay, so let us answer few questions related to this. So here the first question is, convert the following temperature into Celsius scale. So we have to convert the following into the Celsius scale. So the first question is given as 300 Kelvin. It is given in Kelvin and you have to convert it into Celsius scale. Okay, so you can see the solution here. So the basic way how to convert the Kelvin scale into Celsius scale is, when Kelvin scale is given, okay, Kelvin scale will always be equal to Celsius scale plus 273. We have to remember this, as this will be the formula related to the solution. Okay, so here you can see K is equals to 273 plus C. It is always the same formula for everything. Wherever you want to change it, you just have to change the Celsius and Kelvin scale. Okay, so we are having the Kelvin scale here, so we need to find out into the Celsius scale. So what we will do is, we will bring this 273 to the left hand side. Okay, so when we bring this 273 to the left hand side, it will become minus, it will become subtract. Okay, so we'll get the answer as C will be as it is. Okay, C is equal to K minus 273. Okay, so let us substitute K value here. K value is nothing but 300 minus 273. So we'll get the answer as 27 degrees Celsius. So here the Kelvin scale is converted into Celsius scale. Okay, similarly one more question is given here. You can see the question, 573 Kelvin is given and you need to convert this into Celsius scale, the similar one. Okay, so how you can do is the same solution, that is you have to use the formula here. K is equals to 273 plus C. So let us substitute the when we bring this 273 to the left hand side, it will become K minus 273. Okay, so let us substitute the K value here, it as 573. So here after substituting, you will get 573 minus 273, it is nothing but 300 degrees Celsius. So when 573 Kelvin is given, when it is converted into Celsius scale, it is nothing but it will become 300 degrees Celsius. Okay, so this was the solution for the first one question. So let us move to the second question here. So the second question is given as, what is the physical nature of water at, okay, you need to tell the physical nature of water at first one 250 degrees Celsius. So what is the physical nature of water at 250 degrees Celsius? So solution is given, the state of water will be steam or water vapor. That is, directly we can say at 250 degrees Celsius water will be in the gaseous state. It is not liquid, it is not solid, but it will be in the gaseous state. Okay, or we can say it is formed as a steam, or it is formed as the water vapor also. Okay, so the next B one here is at 100 degrees Celsius. So you need to know that 100 degrees Celsius is the temperature scale where the water starts boiling. Okay, so here at this point what happens is, here transition from liquid state to gaseous state takes place. So how the transition is taking place? Just because I told you just now that at 100 degrees Celsius water starts boiling. So boiling in the sense it is changing at this point of temperature, it is changing from liquid state to the gaseous state. Okay, so here they have given, as here the transition from the liquid state into the gaseous state takes place. Okay, so at this temperature the state may be liquid as well as the gaseous. So we cannot tell it may be as a liquid, it may be as a gaseous, because boiling just starts here. Means some of the water will be formed as the gaseous and some of the water will be formed as a liquid. Okay, so moving to the next question, third one. For any substance, why does the temperature remains constant during the change of state? So the question is given as, for any of the substance, why does the temperature always remains constant during the changing of the state? When a substance is changing from solid to liquid state, or liquid to solid state, or whatever state, when it is changing its state, why always the temperature remains constant? So we have to answer for this question now. So let us see the answer here. So solution is given as, during the change of state, the heat or energy provided to the particle of matter. When the state will be changing, whatever the energy we are providing to that particles of matter, it is always utilized in overcoming the force of attraction of the particles. So we all know that when we are changing a substance from solid state to liquid state, what happens there is, we have to actually what happens there is the whatever the heat we are providing to that substance, okay, it is used in the overcoming of the intermolecular force of attraction. So you know that in the solid state what happens, the particles will be tightly packed. It means there will be lots of force of attraction between the two particles. Okay, so when we are heating that particles, the particle will not heat it up, instead it will try to looser their bonds between them. Okay, they will try to loose their bonds between them, and hence what happens here is they use that heat energy to overcome the force of attraction. Okay, then what happens? As a result, the temperature remains constant during the change of state. So we can see the temperature will always remain constant at that state. Okay, so basic example I can give you, when the water is ice, okay, and you are trying to heat that water. So after you provide heat to the water, even though you provide heat to that particular ice, until it is totally melted up, the heat, if you touch the utensil, you will not feel hot. It is just because whatever the temperature you are giving to that particular utensil or that particular ice, it is utilized in this temperature in changing the state of the substance. Okay, but it will not rise its temperature. So this is what happening in this case. Okay, then moving to the next question, fourth one, suggest a method to liquefy atmospheric gases. So we have to suggest a method by which we can liquefy our atmospheric gases. You know that atmospheric gases will be in the gaseous state. So we need to liquefy this gaseous. So we have to suggest a method to liquefy this type of gases. Okay, so let's move to the solution. if we decrease temperature, okay, when we decrease temperature and increase the pressure, if we increase pressure and decrease temperature, we can liquefy the atmospheric gases. So this is one way how we can liquefy the atmospheric gases. Okay, so I hope everything is cleared here. If there is any doubts regarding this, you can comment me down below. And please do not forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.